In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, open the abundance of your kindnesses to request the merits and the desires of those who entreat you. Pour out your mercy upon us, to pardon with conscious breath, and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, please advance to be in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians and to us. Brothers and sisters, realize that it is those who have faith who are children of Abraham. Scripture, which saw in advance that God would justify the Gentiles by faith, foretold the good news to Abraham, saying, "Through you shall all the nations be blessed." Consequently, those who have faith are blessed, along with Abraham, who had faith. For all who depend on works of the law are under a curse. For it is written, "Cursed be everyone who does not persevere in doing all the things written in the book of the law." And that no one is justified before God by the law is clear. For the one who is righteous by faith will live. But the law does not depend on faith. Rather, the one who does these things will live by them. Christ ransomed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. For it is written, "Cursed be everyone who hangs on a tree," that the blessing of Abraham might be extended to the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, so that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. The word of the Lord. Our responsorial psalm, "The Lord will remember his covenant forever."
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart in the company and assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights. Majesty and glory are his work, and his justice endures forever. He has won renown for his wondrous deeds. Gracious and merciful is the Lord.
Lord,
remember his covenant forever. He has given food to those who fear him. He will forever be mindful of his covenant. He has made known to his people the power of his works, giving them the inheritance of the nations. The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The prince of this world will not be cast out. When I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw all to myself, says the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus had driven out the demon, some of the crowd said, "By the power of Beelzebub, the prince of demons, he drives out the demons." Other to test him, ask him for a sign from heaven. But he knew their thoughts and said to them, "Every kingdom divided against itself will be laid waste, and house will fall against house. And if Satan is divided against himself, how will kingdom stand? For you say that it is by Beelzebub that I drive out the demons. If I then drive out the demons by Beelzebub, by whom do your own people drive them out? Therefore they will be your judges. But if it is by the finger of God that I drive out the demons, then the kingdom of God has come upon you. When a strong man fully armed guards his palace, his possessions are safe. But when one stronger than he attacks and overcomes him, he takes away the armor on which he relied and distributes the spoils. Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. When an unclean spirit goes out of someone, it roams through arid regions, searching for rest, but finding none, it says, I shall return to my home from which I came. But upon returning, it finds it swept clean and put in order. Then it goes and brings back seven other spirits, more wicked than itself, and move in and dwell there. And the last condition of that man is worse than the first. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We follow Jesus through the gift of faith. It is a gift given to us all, but we know that not all accept it. Through baptism and other sacraments, our faith grows, and we also grow in grace and virtue. We receive the forgiveness and healing. The power of Jesus is stronger than anything the world or the devil can do. Let us join together as the body of Christ and offer our prayers to the Father. For the Church, may all her members be strengthened by the Holy Spirit in the universal call to holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For and government leaders, may God guide them in their efforts to protect the dignity and the sanctity of life from conception through natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, especially St. Zachary Parish, for whom this mass is offered, may the Lord bless us and make us holy in his sight. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially those who have been forgotten, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we offer our prayers and our hearts to you, to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, God of creation, for the goodness you have sent the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and overflowing hands, and will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, God of creation, for the goodness you have sent the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and overflowing hands, and will become our spiritual bread.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name. for our good and the good of all Holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, the great sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is really right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever, to give you thanks, Lord, for your Father, Almighty, eternal God, that through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise, as about them we are glad.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, as these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body, blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving it thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat up, for this is my God, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving it thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim
your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving it thanks that you have heard us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread it throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis Pope and Blaise, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, and Moses, his spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Zachary, and all the saints that please your God is, we may merit to be coerced in our life, and may praise and glorify you through the Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and grant us repentance in our days, that by the help of your mercy may we always live from sin, and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, we said to your apostles, be thy living, my be thy giving. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we can form, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The message ends with all peace.
Thanks be to God.